Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Dear brothers and sisters, after a person meets their Creator and their deeds have been weighed, and God grants the believers entrance into paradise, we find that the tradition of Jannah, the tradition of paradise in Islam, is something that cannot be likened to this world. As the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that in it is what no man has ever imagined, what no ear has ever heard, and what no eye has ever seen. It is something that is so powerful, so amazing. So, you know, it's something that even the imagination cannot grasp. So in essence, when we see the traditions of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, talking about paradise, and we see the traditions of, or we see the ayat, the verses of the Quran talking about paradise, we see that there is a sense of familiarity in this, that when the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that when the person is entered into paradise, he would go to his home in paradise, and he would recognize the path to his home just as he would recognize the way to his home in this world. So a person would go in, he would recognize the surroundings of paradise, he would walk in, he would go to his palace, and at the same time he would be admiring things. In one tradition, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said a person would gaze and admire at a tree and bask in the shade of that tree for 100 years, or see a flower and gaze at it and admire it for 100 years. Of course, in paradise, you don't have any job to go to, you don't have to worry about anything. And then some people would say, well, what happens in paradise? Are we going to have, are men going to just be able to have as many women as they want? Are women going to be able to have as many men as they want? You know, that doesn't seem fair. What if we're going to have jealousy? What if the husband gets jealous of the wife if she has more than one man? Or the wife gets jealous of the husband if he has more than one woman? And the problem with that is that we always try to grasp paradise sometimes in worldly terms. And in paradise, we know that God has prepared something that makes us all happy, and at the same time, there's no sense of jealousy, there's no sense of hatred, and no one would be alone, no one would be, when we talk about the concept of a woman, for example, entering into paradise, she's not going to become the slave girl of a man, as some people have portrayed. Everyone has their own share of whatever they want in paradise. So they can. Paradise, in essence, is what you want. If you want to be jumping around like Spider-Man in paradise, that's paradise for you. You can have that. Paradise is what you want. But the ultimate pleasure of paradise in Islam is when a person gets to see their Creator in the highest level of paradise. As the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said that in paradise a person would be able to see the face of his Lord. So that could mean that you see him twice a week, or you see him twice a day, or you see him every day, because there will be different levels in paradise also. As far as hellfire is concerned, in the Quran, when we look at the terminology of the Quran, in essence, God says that people send themselves to hell. You know, there's always this question, how can God send people to hellfire? And you know, God says in the Quran, yaslawnaha, that people who have been working in a way or who have been doing the deeds of hellfire, and not considering, not even trying to make an effort to reach paradise, to go back home, because this is where we all originated from, that they would reach their destination of hellfire. But certainly God has no interest in punishing anyone, but at the same time, some people do need to be punished. And so when we look at the description of hellfire, yes, it is a place that is gruesome. Yes, it is a place where punishment takes place. But the greatest punishment of hellfire is that a person has missed out on the opportunity to know their Lord. A person would not be able to call upon God anymore. Whereas in paradise, you can call upon God all the time. You can see God. In hellfire, a person would not be able to call upon God. They would have to ask the angels to ask God certain things. Whereas in Islam, we believe that in this world, you are able to call upon God whenever you want, and in paradise you are able to see him and call upon him and have every request fulfilled. And so the paradise on earth is establishing that relationship with God before you even get to the paradise of the hereafter, and the hell on earth is cutting yourself off from God before you get to the actual hellfire of the hereafter, where you will no longer have that communication. In paradise, the believers congregate, they meet, they come together, they reflect on their worldly lives. There is no grudge between them. There is no sense of hatred. There's, you know, they reflect together, and they ask one another, or they remind one another rather, do you remember when we did this good deed together? Do you remember when we were sitting here and we were listening to this lecture? Do you remember the day that we became Muslim? They sit and they reflect, and they are overjoyed. And at the same time, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that every day, everything in paradise gets more beautiful. So your spouse, for example, every time you see your spouse, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said every time the husband sees the wife, he would say to her, you're more beautiful than yesterday. And the wife would say to the husband, and you're more handsome than yesterday. And so he never gets bored of paradise, because obviously in this world, everything that you use gets boring. It gets old at one point. Everything that you see gets old. I mean, even if you live on an island, you're not going to appreciate that island in the same way after a year or even after a few months. So in paradise, God continues to increase the blessing, increase the favor so that it never gets old. And in hellfire, the punishment continues to increase. Whereas this is for all of eternity. We do believe in Islam, just very quickly, that some people will come from hellfire and will enter into paradise. So going to hellfire in Islam does not necessarily mean that you will be there eternally, but there will be some people who got, you know, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said anyone who has even an atom's worth of faith will eventually be pulled from hellfire and put into paradise. And this is from the great and ultimate and supreme mercy of God. A murderer, an adulterer, a thief, as long as they had some form of faith, eventually they would enter into paradise. And once you enter into paradise, you never leave paradise. So we ask God to grant us paradise. Ameen. Thank you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.